Are you trying to decide if you should buy the latest 2021 12.9 inch iPad Pro? Well, I recently made the switch from my old 11 inch from last year, but did I make a mistake by one, going to a larger size, and two, upgrading this year? Honestly, after the latest WWDC, I'm a little worried. So in this video, I wanted to share my first impressions of Apple's latest iPad, why I decided to go with the larger version, what I was expecting with future updates, and what my recommendations would be if you're trying to choose between the different iPad options out there. So let's go ahead and get right to it. What is up, everybody? It's your boy Noah. If it's your first time here, I make videos on the latest health and productivity tech out there. So if this sounds interesting to you, make sure you hit that subscribe button. So when I initially unboxed the 12.9 inch iPad Pro, I wasn't surprised to see the standard charger, quick start guide, and Apple stickers. But when I took the actual iPad out of the box, I was really taken aback by how big the 12.9 inch was compared to my 11 inch from 2020. It definitely felt a lot larger and wider when holding it out in front of me, especially looking at them side by side. I didn't expect there to be such a significant size difference physically. I guess 2 inches does matter. Also, since I got the 12.9 inch version this time, I had to also upgrade the Magic Keyboard, RIP my wallet. But I'll be honest, I definitely think the larger size and layout of the keys is actually a lot better and provides a more natural typing experience. They both make a perfect pair and a match made in heaven. This combination honestly feels like a mini 13 inch laptop, similar to their older MacBook. Now you may be wondering, what is all the hype around this new iPad? Well, first off is the new addition of their M1 chip, which is the latest hardware upgrade to Apple's MacBook computer lineup, which allows for faster and more efficient processing and also improving power output and battery life. Second is the better graphics performance with now a new included 8-core GPU, which is better for console quality gaming and using augmented reality apps. The third and probably most talked about upgrade was the Liquid Retina XDR display, which contains mini LEDs to allow the iPad Pro to get 2 times brighter at 1600 nits at its peak brightness, and it allows for better contrast by providing deeper blacks. The fourth update was the new Thunderbolt port, which enables faster connection with external storage when transferring files and improving the connection to your external displays. We also got a new ultra-wide front-facing camera, which is 12 megapixels, and a super wide field of view, which enables the use of center stage, where the iPad uses machine learning to follow you or any subject around by zooming in and panning to make sure you are always staying within the frame on FaceTime video calls and Zoom meetings. Lastly, you get the 5G connectivity, similar to the update made for the latest iPhones last year. Now getting into why I upgraded to the larger 12.9 inch iPad Pro. So I got a new job where they gave me a Lenovo laptop as my work computer. Now I don't know about you, but I personally hate bringing two computers around when traveling. By having the 12.9 inch iPad, I'm able to have the same amount of power, but in a smaller footprint that fits easier into my backpack. Which leads me into my second reason, which is I plan to use it as my fully capable creative powerhouse for my everyday content needs. It allows me the ability to do multitasking, leveraging the Files app and making PowerPoint decks, or when it comes to editing photos in Lightroom or creating thumbnails in Photoshop, even note-taking with my Apple Pencil where I can convert my notes to text, and hopefully basic editing for these YouTube videos when I'm on the go, which honestly, I was really hoping to hear about some sort of update to the iPad Pro that would allow it to use Final Cut, but no dice. And third, I just wanted a better content consumption experience with the better mini LED display, larger size, and with already great speakers, I can fully enjoy movies, music, and gaming, and just have a better overall experience with this device. After all of that, what would I recommend when it comes to either upgrading or buying a new iPad? Well, honestly, when people ask me that question, I actually ask them, which category do they fit in? These categories are, number one, the everyday user who would use their iPad for basic tablet needs. This is everything from web surfing and average social media consumption, and they're looking for a quality, cost-conscious option. The standard iPad Air is the best choice for this group, and honestly, what I would say would be great for 75 to 80% of the people out there. Number two is the traveler. This is someone who is looking for a pro tablet that's portable. They might be looking to pair it with the MacBook Air or Pro as an extra screen on the go. This is where I think the iPad Pro 11 inch would be the perfect fit for this group. I loved having my 11 inch when I was traveling and on the go. Third is the super user, which is someone who wants a maxed out iPad powerhouse, something with the bells and whistles that they can almost use as a standalone device. They might be the person who has a desktop iMac at home and want an almost just as powerful device with a larger screen for when they're out and about. This is where I think the latest 2021 iPad Pro 12.9 inch would be the perfect match for that person. The ultimate iPad for the ultimate tablet user. Personally, I still think the 2018 and the 2020 iPad Pro are still great power options to buy at this time. But what about you? Which camp do you see yourself fitting in? In fact, that's the question of the day. Which iPad do you feel like is right for you? Let me know in the comments below. So yeah, those are my final thoughts on the 12.9 inch 2021 iPad Pro. Did I make a mistake by getting the latest larger version? I personally don't think so. I've already adjusted to the size and I love having a lot of that extra power. However, I am really, really praying and hoping that Apple is going to provide more substantial updates to the iPad OS in the near future. We'll just have to see what Apple has in the pipeline for the iPad. I feel like they're making these iPads so powerful that they could just stand on their own. I just need Apple to get their act together and make it happen. Anyway, that wraps up today's video. I hope it was helpful. If it was, go ahead and pound that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and you already know, stay healthy, stay productive, and embrace the hype. Woo!